It's true that ice is a particular type of drug that acts quickly and then wears off quickly and you need it again very quickly. But it's definitely not true that any person suddenly uses ice once and they become addicted. That's just not true.
Now, about 1 in 70 Australians will have tried ice in the last 12 months. And then if you look at how many of them are using it weekly or daily, it's about 1 in 5 of those 1 in 70. So not all of them. So for me, those sort of figures say that if you've used ice once, you're hooked, isn't really the way people are experiencing ice.
It's not everything that you see or that you can see on the TV. And I was definitely a little bit scared of it because, yeah, I thought that you would just end up throwing chairs through windows and stuff like that.
It's the people that are using ice all day, every day, that are more visible to the community, which leads to the perception that that's the only way people are using ice. And depending on the effect the drug has on them, depending on what other kind of social supports they have around them, it's not cut and dried often, but the impact can be considerable.
Now, dopamine and noradrenaline, they are the chemicals in your brain that lead to euphoria. And ice actually increases the amount of those neurochemicals in your brain.
I was just kind of almost shocked that it was so good, but it didn't stay like that for very long.
Unfortunately, what happens is while they increase it, it increases them in the first instance, after a while they can actually deplete, and then the only way you can start to feel normal is when you're on ice.
I definitely think that once people become addicted to it, it's very, very hard to then just control it yourself, from what I've seen anyway.
You can spend a lot of your time thinking about the drug, seeking the drug, working out how to get the drug, and that starts to become the priority in your life.
And look, the worst thing about it all was that I was incredibly depressed. I had suicide attempts and was just in a very, very dark place at the end of it all.
It can be quite harmful to a person physically and mentally. But I certainly think that it's absolutely possible to stop using the drugs in a harmful way and get on with the rest of your life.
Having someone share their story with me that I could relate to really broke through some of the barriers that I had, and it allowed me to get to that place where then I could do the work with them professionally to work on my underlying issues, which then eventually helped me to get clean and turn it around.
It won't necessarily happen in a short period of time. It may take a period of intensive treatment, and it may take a high level of commitment from the individual and from their families and from their friends, but it is definitely very possible to recover from serious ice addiction.